The National Center for Environmental Health protects people from harmful exposures in the air we breathe, the water we drink, the food we eat, and the world that sustains us. We do this by investigating relationships between environmental factors, such as hazardous chemicals and radiation, and health, and using this information to develop guidance in order to minimize or reduce these harmful exposures. To fulfill this mission, we work with local and state partners by developing guidance that's evidence-based and providing technical expertise. In this video, you'll hear about some of the important work we do here at the National Center for Environmental Health.
Biomonitoring is the measurement of environmental chemicals in human specimens, like in blood or in urine. And it's especially valuable because it integrates all the exposures that people have to different environmental chemicals. If it comes from air or water or soil or food, wherever it comes from, once it gets into the body, we actually measure what gets into the body. The level that gets in the body is probably the most health relevant level. So that's the level we're most concerned with when we're trying to protect the public's health. In our laboratory, we have lots of biomonitoring measurements. We can measure over 350 chemicals in blood or serum or urine. And these range from things like lead, cadmium, arsenic, mercury, to all sorts of pesticides, to persistent organic pollutants like dioxins and furans and PCBs, to polychlorinated biphenyls, to a whole lot of different compounds that we're exposed to in the environment today, for which we want to make sure people are protected from harmful exposures.
All Americans have a right to clean water. One of the things that we have here at the National Center for Environmental Health is a program called Safe Watch, Safe Water for Community Health. And what that is a program where we help state health departments improve their environmental health programs and talk about drinking water. How do we improve those drinking water systems here in the United States and make them healthier and safe to drink?
One of the things that can happen when people get water from huge water body sources is that they're subject to whatever is going on in that water body. And Lake Erie, over the last couple of decades, has been subject to very extensive microcystis blooms, and it produces a toxin called microcystin. If you're exposed to microcystin in large doses, it can cause liver problems and kidney problems. What happened in Toledo was that they were drawing water from an area that had an extensive bloom. And when they treated the drinking water, it did not get rid of all of the toxins. So there were very, very small amounts of the toxin left in the drinking water in the community. CDC had a big response in terms of helping them get enough drinking water to the community, and we also helped with issues like whether or not a hospital could use water that had microcystin in it, whether or not children should be playing in the water, whether restaurants could use the water to cook food. So there was a lot of different things that we were providing technical assistance with.
CDC's Climate and Health Program is tasked with preparing the U.S. public health infrastructure for the health consequences of climate change. We do this in numerous ways. We develop the science to assess how climate change will impact health. We also work with our partners to identify regional threats that they might be experiencing within their jurisdiction. We help them understand how those threats might play within their area, identify vulnerable populations, and understand how patterns of disease or disease epidemiology might change into the future as a result of climate change.
Environmental public health tracking, I tend to think of as public health surveillance supersized. It is the ongoing collection, integration, management, analysis, and dissemination of data on health, on environmental conditions, and on exposures. It encompasses the people at both at CDC and at the state and local levels who are engaged in the program. It encompasses the resources to make things happen, and it encompasses the National Environmental Public Health Tracking Network, which is really the cornerstone of the program.
We have made tremendous strides in the area of childhood lead poisoning prevention. So what we do here is a lot of childhood lead poisoning surveillance. We work with state and local health departments to make sure that they are collecting data, screening their children, and collecting the information they need to really find those children that are at high risk. We call that primary prevention. We do a lot of secondary prevention where we fund state and local health departments to have a childhood lead poisoning prevention program. This year we were able to fund 29 states, 5 local big cities, and the District of Columbia.
The National Center for Environmental Health is on the front lines of protecting the public's health. We work with thousands of dedicated local and state health department officials in order to implement programs to promote health, to prepare for and respond to emergencies, to achieve our vision of healthy people in healthy environments.